สวัสดีค่ะ This is the experiment number 5 Coordination complex The objectives are For part 1 To study the effect of ligand to the color of complex ion For part number 2 To determine the hardness of water by measuring the concentration of calcium ion in water sample by titration.
Part 1, color of complex ion. So from lecture, you know that complex ion are color. This is because of the transition of electron within the orbital need energy in the visible region of electromagnetic spectrum. And because of the ligand type, this will create a crystal splitting with different energy. So the delta crystal splitting energy delta depends on the ligand type, which will change color of the solution. So again, when you change ligand in the complex, the color of solution will be changed as well. So we will see in this experiment here. From the spectrochemical series, we have different types of ligand, from the strong field to the weak field. Okay, and we have the conclusion from the lecture that strong field ligand will create large delta. So this complex will absorb the shorter wavelength of light, and you will see the complementary color using this color wheel. For example, if your complex ion absorb the light in this region, you will see it's in violet. So let's see if you can take this theory to explain what happened on the laboratory, นะคะ. Part 1. So the solution that are used in this experiment, นะคะ. Ammonia, copper sulfate, and concentrated hydrochloric acid. So step of doing experiment, number 1, transfer 1 milliliter of copper sulfate solution to test tube and observe the color. This color is the color of complex hexa-aqua copper 2 ion.
Number 2. Carefully adding concentrated hydrochloric acid a few drops into the solution and observe the color change. This is the color of complex ion tetrachlorocuprate 2. Then number 3, transfer copper sulfate solution in the new test tube. And then adding ammonia solution and see the color change. This time it is the color of complex ion tetraamine diaqua copper 2 ion. Number 4. Carefully adding concentrated hydrochloric acid again in the same test tube and observe the color change. Now that you see all the colors of the complex ion in your report, explain this change of color of the complex ion with respect to the change of ligands. We change ligands aqua, amine, and chloral. See the spectrochemical series and explain about the change in color that you observe from.
Now part 2, determination of water hardness. In this experiment, the water sample will be analyzed for the combined of concentration of calcium and magnesium ion, and this is known as the total hardness of water. For simplicity, in this experiment, we will report the total amount of calcium ion and magnesium ion as the concentration of calcium ion only. The quantity of hardness ion will be determined by the titration method. The solution need for this experiment part 2 are shown here in this slide. You will need EDTA as your titrant, the magnesium chloride, the buffer and indicator, ureochrome black tea. The titration setup, you will need a burette and a stand to hold your burette, and you will need other glassware like flask and pipette and other things. The titration, the main component for this method, you will need titrant and you will need the sample. Again, the titrant is the EDTA solution. The analyte is your water sample that will have ion, calcium ion and magnesium ion in the sample of water. The indicator, ureochrome black tea, will indicate the endpoint. In this experiment, we will need to add other reagents to support the ion in the solution to get the best result. You need to add buffer solution, and in this particular experiment we use buffer of ammonia and ammonium ion, and that the pH is pH equal to 10. This pH will keep the EDTA in the form of dihydrogen form, that this form will react very well with calcium ion and magnesium ion. You also need to add the magnesium chloride solution. This will be referred to as the internal standard because we have to add this into every solution equally. This magnesium chloride solution will ensure that the starting of titration would be in the red color. Otherwise, you will never be able to find the endpoint. The reaction that involved in the titration are listed here. You will have three reactions. Number one is the reaction between EDTA and the ion of interest in your sample, and that would be calcium ion plus magnesium ion, but for simplicity, we will refer to it as calcium ion only. Reaction number two is the reaction between EDTA and the internal standard magnesium ion that we added into the solution. Reaction number three is the EDTA react with the indicator. With the indicator here will bind with magnesium first to be in red, and then EDTA will compete with indicator and it will bind with magnesium ion better to make this complex. The indicator that lose magnesium ion will change color into blue, which is why if in your solution you don't have magnesium ion, the indicator will never be in red. Go back to the reason for you need to add internal standard. You need to add a fixed amount of this solution in every sample that you analyze. From the previous slide that you see, we have three reactions happened in the analysis. So to be able to know only the amount of EDTA required for ion of interest in your sample only, you need to know first how much is the EDTA that react with the internal standard and the indicator. That is the reason for the blank titration. In blank titration, blank means blank of sample of interest, which means say you have three reactions in blue, in green, in yellow. The blank, the blue one is blank. The green and yellow are exactly the same as in your water sample. So the titration here in blank, the EDTA, total volume of EDTA, is the volume that react with internal standard and the indicator. Let's say you do the titration and you have the result of total volume of EDTA is X milliliter. When you do water sample titration, this time you have ion of interest in your sample and that require EDTA to react with it also, which means that the total volume of EDTA required to reach the endpoint here would be higher than that for the blank. Say you got the Y milliliter. Y must be more than X because Y is the EDTA react for ion of interest, react with internal standard, react with indicator. But X is the EDTA react with only internal standard and indicator. Now let's see the experiment step of doing titration. We will do the blank titration first. Number one, you're gonna have to prepare your sample. This time, the blank titration, we will use purified water. So you pipette the purified water into the flask. Purified water here, we expect zero ion of interest. So this is blank zero. When you pipette the purified water already, next you're gonna add the buffer in. So you will pipette the fixed amount of buffer. It is important that you keep everything exactly the same between blank and sample. The only difference would be the ion of interest. Everything else must be exactly the same. Next step, you add magnesium chloride solution. In this experiment, you get to use pipette quite a lot. And the final step is to add indicator. So we use the earlier chrome black tea, a few drops, and that should be in red color because we have indicator and we have magnesium ion in there. Now we are ready for the titration. You have to set up the burette with the titrant. In this experiment means you have to fill the burette up with EDTA solution. And I hope that you still remember how to set up the burette and what's it called. Make sure that you remove the bubbles at the the end, the tip of the burette. Okay? Now everything is set up. Record the initial volume of EDTA in the burette, and then start the titration. One hand hold the flask and keep swirling it. Another hand control the stopper. Okay? Keep stir, swirl the solution. The end point is solution turned into blue, like this. Then you stop the titration and record the final volume of EDTA. The total volume of EDTA here are the volume that used to react with internal standard and the magnesium ion in indicator. The next step is do the titration of the water sample. The step is exactly the same. Number one, pipette sample water. This sample of water is expected to have ion of interest, so you get this reaction in the line in blue. And then you add everything else, add buffer, add magnesium chloride solution, and then add indicator. And the solution ready for titration must be in red color. And then you are ready for the titration. Record the initial volume of EDTA in the burette and start your titration. Control the stopper and then use another hand to swirl the flask continuously. This time we expect three reactions, so the total volume of EDTA will be higher than the blank titration, so you're gonna need a longer time for the titration. The end point is the same. The red color solution would change into blue. Keep doing so. It's gonna be longer. So it's nearly there. Now it's done. Okay. When you see the blue color, you will stop the titration. And then you record the final volume of EDTA. This is the volume, total volume for EDTA to react with three reactions. Now, to do the calculation, as I said earlier, we only interest in the EDTA react with ion of interest in our sample only. So you have to subtract the volume of EDTA used for blank from that of volume of EDTA used for water sample. And that's gonna be the volume of EDTA replaced in this formula. We want this reaction alone. So you know number of mole of EDTA react with number of mole of calcium ion. The mole ratio here is 1:1, which is why we get this formula. Concentration of calcium ion in molar is equal to concentration of EDTA solution, and that is 0.01 molar, times volume of EDTA used for this particular reaction only. divided by the water sample volume, and that is 10 milliliter. When you get concentration of calcium ion in molar, change this into the water hardness level, that is the equivalent of calcium carbonate in the ppm unit. To change molarity to ppm of calcium carbonate, you use this formula. Replace the number here to here for molarity of calcium ion. Multiply by molecular weight of calcium carbonate. You're gonna get that yourself. And then multiply by 10 raised to 3. And this is the way to calculate the water hardness. When you get this number, the report for the level of water hardness, and this is the classification for the hardness of the water sample. If it is a soft water, doesn't have the ion, calcium ion very much. Soft water have equivalent calcium carbonate from 0 to 17.1 ppm only, but for the very hard water have the equivalent calcium carbonate in ppm 180 ppm or over that. So in your report, you're gonna make the conclusion from the titration results, get the amount of calcium ion and change into the water hardness level, and then report it. Identify your sample as soft water, or is it a hard water, or is it a very hard water?